Good morning, I'm Trey Thies. Well, Advent has sped by this year. Advent, our parish's eponymous season, and the season of the church year, which has really become a personal favorite of mine. I thought today we might look at the texts of some of the great Advent hymns. I think these Advent hymns together comprise the most beautiful set of seasonal hymns that we have. All of the tunes are familiar, and I won't attempt the tune, but I think that the words are very telling. They speak to what I love about Advent, the multiple dimensions of the season. We wait quietly. We wait hopefully and expectantly. There's a penitential element as well. And then I love the growing sense of wonder as I think about Christ coming into the world as a child and then as a teacher and guide and friend, but ultimately as Savior dying for us. And then a sense of awe when I consider that Christ will come again as judge and king. And in all of this, these hymn texts combine and layer these various dimensions of Advent to make what for me is a very, very hopeful and appealing vision of where all of this is headed. So first, come thou long expected Jesus, born to set thy people free. From our fears and sins release us. Let us find our rest in thee. And the third verse, born thy people to deliver, born a child and yet a king, born to reign in us forever, now thy gracious kingdom bring. The themes and dimensions are layered one on another, past, present, and future. Another very well-known hymn, hark a thrilling voice is sounding, Christ is nigh, it seems to say. Cast away the works of darkness, O ye children of the day. Lo, the Lamb, so long expected, comes with pardon down from heaven. Let us haste with tears of sorrow, one and all to be forgiven. Layer upon layer. And then the hymns speak of the second coming with great, great majesty, and the most majestic hymn of all, and my second favorite among the Advent hymns, is this one. Lo, he comes with clouds descending, once for our salvation slain, thousand saints attending, swell the triumph of his train. Alleluia, alleluia, Christ the Lord returns to reign. And then we come to my favorite Advent hymn, which is Sleepers Awake. One quick story about this hymn. Philip Nicolai in the 16th century wrote this during a plague year. It was 1598, and he had been closely affected by this. He was a Lutheran pastor, and his congregation was suffering mightily. And suddenly he came to a place of peace, and he concluded that, well, if I should succumb to the plague, let me at least leave something beautiful behind after me, this hymn. And if I survive, then let me rededicate myself to helping others. Quite a beautiful story. So let's go to the second verse where he bridges from the bridegroom and the wise and foolish virgins and the wedding guests into the New Jerusalem, and here that's under the heading Zion, which was the hill outside of Jerusalem, then became the word for Jerusalem itself, and then all of Israel, and now by extension all of us. Zion hears the watchman singing, her heart with joyful hope is springing. She wakes and hurries through the night. Forth he comes, her bridegroom glorious, in strength of grace, in truth victorious. Her star is risen, her light grows bright. Now come, most worthy Lord, God's Son, incarnate Word. Alleluia! We follow all and heed your call to come into the banquet hall. Advent, the coming of Christ, the second coming of Christ, and at any time, the coming of Christ into our own hearts. It's really a story of the kingdom happening now, if we'll only let it. Let us pray. Lord of all Advents, who didst come in the fullness of time and shall again, by the power of thy Holy Spirit, fill our hearts with hope this Advent tide, that we may journey expectantly where thou wouldst have us go, for there we shall surely find thee. Amen.